2021-08.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. This is another rezoning request. This is by Scot Dowdy. The rezoning currently of our piece of land, about 47 acres. It's currently approximately split half R-10 and the other half E-R. Proposal to rezone all of it to R-6 for the purposes of the same type of residential subdivision. Established residential is the character area, which includes all forms of residential zoning. When you look at the zoning pattern that's around, of course, you have single family residential on this side of Jaycee Shack, but if you look to the west side, you have multi-family residential, and also an old PRD development, which was high density residential. There's a mixture of R6 type houses and even, I think, some duplexes in there. That's an approval from almost 20 years ago. Part of the reason the properties on the west side have not developed yet is the good old fashioned railroad track in the way. As you look at the area is surrounded by undeveloped land, and it's not something you see very often, but it is truly the dominant pattern here. Inside the inner perimeter of Valdosta, this is not in your packet, but I put it in the PowerPoint. This is from just a few years ago, but from 14 years ago, the 07 imagery is a little higher resolution. Here you can kind of see the differences in the trees, and it corresponds with some of the wetlands areas that are on the site. Wetlands have been delineated, as has the floodplain on the currently official map, which may be changing. And as the engineer, I'm sure, will tell you, it's really the wetlands boundary that's the more important thing here, because that's really going to be indicative of the floodplain. So here is how the property currently lies, and they have done as a preliminary concept an R6 subdivision around the wetlands. With quite a few lots, 123 lots, the R6 standards are a little bit higher. And you see there's still some land where they could possibly bend and shape and tweak a little bit. Probably have a little bit of a variety of lots. The wetlands that are on the half of the property bend around to the west a little bit underneath the property, and then come up most of the east side. There might be some opportunities for stub outs into some of these properties, but all of that becomes a point of discussion during the subdivision plat review. But for demonstration purposes, under R6, about 125 lot subdivision is what they can get here with the similar type pattern. This is not an actual plat, but it is the beginnings of one. Of course, we're tonight looking at a rezoning change and out here to approve the subdivision plat. Subject property, Jaycee Shack Road, has a little bit of a familiarity with Ulmer, except a lot less development on both sides. Part of the property is already partially cleared, and across the street, the railroad track with the vacant land is beyond. And then looking down the street, even going a little further south, this is near the south edge of the property. And as you can see, the view has not changed a whole lot. So with that, staff has found it consistent with the conference plan, the standards for exercise of zoning power, which are there in the packet, and we're recommending approval of R6.
Questions? All righty. Is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak on behalf of this request?
Good evening. My name is Bill Kent. I'm with Innovate Engineering, 2214 North Patterson Street. I'm here on behalf of the owner who is in the audience, if there's any questions for him. As was stated by staff, the development pattern in this part of the city is for a more dense residential pattern, so that's what we've laid out. And it's conceptual, of course. We know we will have to conform with all development standards in the city in terms of lot size, utilities, stormwater, landscaping, etc. So, we're glad to answer any questions.
Do any of the commissioners have questions? All right. Thank you, Mr. Kent.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else here tonight who wishes to speak? speak on behalf of this request?
My name is Jack Langdale, 701 North Patterson. I'm not here representing Mr. Dowdy. I just wanted to offer an observation as a real estate attorney now. The housing crisis in the market, as everyone knows, and the skyrocketing prices and houses are selling. There are very few houses on the market, and the size of the lots being foreclosed, there's really not much like it anywhere. The demand is there. So there's a big need for this size lot in this area of town. They did a development across the street, the high height subdivision, which was comparable, and those houses sold before they could finish. So there's a high demand in the area. Also, I've worked with Mr. Dowdy before in the near town. He's done several subdivisions out there, Patriots Point. He's worked some in North Moody subdivision. He's done an excellent job. Everything I've seen, he's kept the subdivisions clean, high quality construction.
Question for you, just out of curiosity, what's the average day on the market now? 36 hours, 48?
It depends on how it's priced. If the realtors are pricing the house according to the comps, if they put on the market on Friday, they expect to get offers throughout the weekend, and the calls are high for the best on Monday. So some people see this and they set prices really high. If they do that, those houses will hang around for a while. But if a realtor pricing according to comps, so that they can give us a regular multiple offer situation.
That's crazy times. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, is there anyone else who wishes to speak on behalf? All right, is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak against this request? Please come forward. Anyone wishing to speak against? All right, if not, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any final discussion, questions. All right, there being none, call for a motion.
Madam Chairman,
there's
only a request of VA-2021-08. I recommend and go with staff to recommend approval.
Okay. We have a motion to approve. Do we have a second? Second by Commissioner Willis. Any discussion on the motion? All those in favor to approve, raise your right hand. All those against, motion carries unanimously.